Welcome everybody at JKU campus, the most beautiful one in Austria. Please study here. Therese is here, my niece. Yeah? Maybe you decide to study here. Let's talk about Johannes Kepler. He calculated the orbit, the precession of planets around the sun in this 17th century. And 400 years approximately later, 55 years ago, these tremendously good, fantastic photo was done by William Anders on Apollo 7. They flew to the moon, the dark side on the moon, and then he realized that something is coming up, and this is the Earth. Yeah, this is blue marble Earth, and the photo was called the Earthrise. Why am I showing this to you? Yeah? So we zoom in and see the atmosphere, the thin layer atmosphere with the clouds, so water clouds. And if we go further on more, and you see this 120 kilometers thin Earth, which protects us from the empty, it's not empty space because we have dark matter, I think, but we have this empty space and the solar radiation, and 120 kilometers, you know, is from Linz to Salzburg, from Linz to St. Pölten. It's not very far. So we go through the atmosphere, down the thermosphere, mesosphere, stratosphere, and then to the troposphere, and we have a problem. The troposphere, we know, there occurs the weather, the climate, and this is only 12 kilometers thin. Huh? And we have a problem. Thank you. Here we have this CO2 molecule, very small one. I did it yesterday, and I don't have a bigger model. So we have plenty of them in our troposphere, namely 417 ppm in the atmosphere. Sounds not very much. Yeah? It's 417 molecules per 1 million. Yeah? It's not much, but only these molecules vibrate when a sun radiation comes to it. And this causes the warming of this troposphere. Huh? And we realize this in this year because this is the warmest year since 125,000 years, I heard yesterday in the broadcast of Ö1. So we have here a record high in 2022. So the thing is, was it forever like this? So since thousands of years, we had this function here, this CO2 concentration in the troposphere, and it was like approximately around 280 ppm. But since the mid of this, the last century, in 1950s, we came to the idea that we built cars and had chemical industry and oxidized the carbon, the fossil fuels, coal, we oxidized this to CO2. And starting from the 1950s, the level of concentration rose dramatically. Yeah? So how, you know, the consequences, yeah? Polar ice melting. The poor ice bear here. Devastating forest fires we saw all over the world. Storms and floodings. Yeah? And this will increase because we are not in a 1.5 degrees Celsius a warming regime, but we are in a 3.5 now. And Mr. Schellenhuber from Potsdam Institute of Climate Forschung did a talk in Linz a few years ago here, and he said, if we do so, we have 9 degrees over the next 400 years. And you know what happens then. Yeah. So this should show these pictures here. So how do we lower the concentration of such greenhouse gases? And we came up with a solution in my lab. So I started the research in 2015 to reduce CO2, like from flue gas, and in flue gas means in German Rauchgas, has 17% of CO2 volume percent. So we can convert with water, this is the water here, CO2, in an apparatus, in an instrumentation powered by renewable energy, like from wind or from solar panels, with the dance of electrons in these electrochemical cells here, to something useful, to useful chemicals. Okay? So useful chemicals are here carbon monoxide. I will speak about this a little later. Formic acid, methanol, methane, ethanol, and ethylene. And all these products we are able to produce. You see here the market sizes of these products per kilogram. So this is pretty cool. So now what are we doing in the lab? Yeah? And you can do then later on in the evening or in the afternoon a trip with me to the lab. I will show you. So we synthesize catalysts. And Dominic Krisch, one of my PhD students, who is now a postdoc, he synthesizes these compounds here. These are catalysts. And normally, CO2 is a very stable molecule. It doesn't like to react very nicely. Yeah? So catalysts lower the activation barrier, and all of a sudden the reaction works. And this is a silver complex, pretty nicely colored. And then we do a magic ink. Don't tell you this, because otherwise you do this. We mix it, and then we spray coat it on cheap electrodes, gas diffusion electrodes. And then we put it into an electrochemical cell. Thank you very much. And on the anode, you have the oxidation of water to oxygen and protons going to a membrane. And on the cathode side, the CO2 reduction takes place, okay, with the help of these protons which are developed on the anode side. And this is very schematic here. I can show this to you in the lab then. We have an H-type cell, but now we constructed, not I constructed this, but Dr. Sun He, a former postdoc in my lab, constructed such prototype cells. Okay? So where you have principally the same thing, cathode side, anode side, membrane, and then you reduce this on the carbonaceous material. And I have a second one, thanks very much, here, which converts liquid products. So you need to saturate CO2 in a liquid product, and then you can do the same thing. You can watch this later on, okay? So I told you I will talk a little bit about syngas. Syngas is a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. And this is a very, very good starting material for industry, for Fischer-Tropsch reaction to methanol, for example. Yeah? So we will have in the future methanol economy. So everything will be built on methanol, hydrogen, and ammonia. And this is one of the brick stones, how we can change to a sustainable world. Okay? So that I'm not telling you any fake here. I'm a researcher, so I don't do fake here. So I want to convince you now with an experiment in the lab that I'm doing something useful here. So here we go with CO2 to humidification. So water is added, and then we go into the cell. And now Dominic Krisch goes to with a carbon monoxide detector. And you see here this is sensitive to carbon monoxide. So carbon monoxide is produced and hydrogen. Okay. And now we set up this bigger system here to have a TRL level. This is the technical readiness level. So we should go now for industry scale. So we would like to go then to higher amounts of CO2 reduction. So, and I want to show you these catalysts, especially because this is one of the world record holder, which has published this now in a good show. And you see here the current density dependence and then the ratio of carbon monoxide to hydrogen. And we can do this at very high current densities already. And this is interesting for industry because they want to push this to the limit and produce a lot of this syngas. Okay. So now I want to show you our upscaling strategy, and I'm coming to my vision now, which I tell you, and please keep it secret. It won't be secret. But we go with CO2, yeah, as a resource from air or from flue gas here. And we have the energy from, as I said, wind or solar panels. And we go on the second floor onto with the electrocatalytic CO2 reduction, what I explained to you today. And in the first floor, we have then the conversion of the syngas, the CO and hydrogen, during a bioprocess, a biocatalysis, to higher, more complex molecules, like aromatics or higher alcohols or organic acids, for example. Yeah? And these are feedstock chemicals for pharmaceutical industry. So we convert directly from CO2 to complex molecules. Okay. So and in the ground floor, we have the collection of the liquid products, the separation, and then we can deal with this in further way. So finally, I wanted to convince you, let us reduce and turn CO2 to something useful. So, and let's turn the threat into a chance. And that's it for today. Thanks very much.